Hi everyone, Jeremy Schaefer here. So you know those little flu bugs that go around getting us all sick? Well, did you know that they're actually little blue men? And with this swatter, you can get them. Ooh, there's one now. Got it. Whoa, check them out. Yes, so this is the man swatter, and I'm gonna teach it to you by popular request, since so many of you signed that petition that was on my last video. So, all right, man swatter, here goes. This is a model that I designed and published in my first book, Origami, to Astonish and Amuse. All right, so, page 234, and we're going to fold it from a sheet of foil. You could use paper, but foil just gives the model a nice body. And I'm gonna show you a little technique that I like to do in order to make the white side of the foil a little bit more interesting. We're going to paint it with acrylic paint. And I'm gonna use this turquoise blue because I like to say at the end of the model that there's these little blue men that are running about and you can catch them. So yeah, you don't really need to wet it, but yeah, I guess you could, depending on the color, a little bit of water. And I'm using a big brush. And the important part is the sides. So what you wanna do in order to avoid painting the other side of the foil, what you wanna do is keep it in one position and make your strokes go this way, like that, and then move it. You see a little bit, a millimeter that way, and then continue. One, two, three, again, move it, like that. It, you see? And hopefully this back is paper that you don't need. Okay. The acrylic also gives it a nice body, so I like using acrylic, and it also makes it waterproof. Alright, so far so good. All right, so here's the painted piece of foil, and yeah, it did okay. And set that out to dry. All right, so it's all painted, and we have gold for the swatter, and blue for the man. So we're gonna start out, fold it diagonally in half. A kite base, so I'm folding this edge right to the middle, diagonal. Okay, now we're going to fold this corner to this corner. And now fold this corner to this corner. And unfold. Alright, turn it over and fold this flap up right between the two corners. Alright. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold this edge right up to this crease, but we really only need to crease right on this crease right here. So we just pinch right there. And now we're going to fold to that pinch mark right here. And now fold to that pinch mark. And now fold to that inch mark. And on this fold, we fold it all the way across. Okay, and let's do the same thing on this part. Well, you know what? You can just match it. That was the only real part that we had to paint, so all of this is extra. But it gives body to the swatter, so anyway, and it's pure. Okay, so now we're going to turn it over, and we have this, and we have that, and now we're going to fold them both together, and this comes up and squash. Like a square base. Alright, and now we take this edge and fold it onto the diagonal. And repeat on this side. And I guess we can zoom in. Alright, let's relocate. And fold this flap right up like that. And pull these flaps out. And let's rotate. And now what we're going to do is we're going to fold right along this line. We're just lifting this edge up. We're going to fold it right on this line and make it go all the way across, like this, and flatten this down like that. Okay, now we take this flap and fold it like this, and we're going to repeat on this side. So we fold right on this edge. Wrap it around that edge. And now we flatten this down and squash. Okay, and let's fold this back down. And now fold this flap up. Okay, and fold this corner to this corner, and same thing on this side. Okay, and now we're going to squeeze here so that this edge lines up there, and we're going to make this edge go right onto the center crease, like that, and we fold this corner up to here, so we squash it down like that. This edge goes here, and this edge comes up to here. Now we're going to fold this down like this, and this down like that. Okay, and fold this edge like that, and then to here. I'm gonna make a rabbit ear. that. And flatten it to here. And flatten it to this side. And now squash it down. And we're just squashing it. Like that. And now fold it back up. And pull out the layers back here and just pull them out and flatten them. See, there's the corner, the layers pulled out. And you just fold it behind. And flatten. Okay. And now fold this corner like that. And this is the head of our dude. And you can round it to taste. Alright, now what we're going to do is fold this edge to right here. And we're going to fold this down so that this is parallel to that. Let's do the same thing on this side. So there we pretty much have our guy, but we're gonna do a little bit more. All right, so now what we're gonna do is fold these arms up. This is really to taste. You just wanna try to make it look like an arm. And this side too. Okay, and now take this flap and this'll be the hand right there. You see? Okay, and let's do something with one of the legs. We're going to fold it up, and you can line it up with this folded edge right here, and then fold it back down. Just make sure that it's a little tiny bit lower than the arm. And it should be parallel to this fold right here. Okay. And now fold this down like this. Let's see? Right between this point and this point. And lift this edge up and just put it down like that. There is the leg. All right, now we're going to zoom out. So we want to fold this flap, and we want it to be parallel to this edge right here. And it should hit this point. If you really want to make sure that it's parallel, you can fold this up, and that'll give you an idea of the perfect line. You see, if we fold this up here, then you can see how it's parallel. Okay. And the same thing on this flap. So here we can just sort of match it right to this point. Okay, and unfold, and now fold this We're folding this edge to the crease that we just made. And same thing here, fold this edge to the crease. Okay, and now we're going to fold this edge to the crease. And same thing on this side. Alright, so now we're going to sink this triangle and the same thing on this side. So you might want to just remake this fold, and you can even turn it into a mountain fold just to make the sinking a little bit easier. So just make this a genderless crease, meaning it's not mountain and it's not valley, it's just a crease. Okay. Now, stick your finger in here, and you're just going to very carefully push it in. We're just sinking it inside so it sticks in. Like that. And make it go all the way down. And the same thing on this side. Alright, there it is. Now fold this as a valley fold, and we're aiming right for the bottom of the foot. See? And let's do a rabbit ear. So we're going to fold this edge to this edge. And unfold, and now we're going to fold this edge to that same edge. And now fold along this vertical, just a valley fold. And as we do that, we're going to form a rabbit ear. Very long rabbit ear. There it is. And now, fold it down like this. Okay. And rotate. And now we're going to fold this edge to right here. Crease sharply and now fold this edge to that same crease that we just made. And now we need to put a crease right in between here. So we're going to fold that same crease. We're going to fold it to this edge. So you can line it up. You see the crease lines up with this edge. And if you want, you can line it up on the other side too. Right there. Okay. And fold. And so here we have our three creases. And now unfold. And We're going to unfold again like this. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is a pleat. First valley, and then the mountain is right on the second crease here. All right, so now we're gonna fold this flap, and we're going to fold it between this point right here and this point, which is 1, 2, 3 right here. So we're gonna make a valley fold diagonal. You see it goes from this point to here. Alright, now we're going to make this valley fold on the existing fold. So what we're going to do is open up the flap that we just folded and just fold right along this existing crease, and we're going to flatten it just like that. And now we're going to fold along the next existing crease, just a simple valley fold on all layers. And now we're going to make a valley fold right here and squash. I'm going to show that again. Maybe zoom in a little bit more. Okay, so we folded like this, and now we're going to fold from this corner to right here, a valley fold. And as we make that fold, it lifts the layers out and releases them, and that lets us squash like that. Okay, now we're going to make the remaining existing crease a valley fold, and this time it goes up to here, and we can just make a squash right there. Like that. Okay, and now we're gonna repeat all of those steps on this flap. So we fold from here to the third crease here, right here. And now we're gonna fold along this existing crease, and we have to turn it into a valley. And squash it. Okay, now fold along this crease. And we're gonna fold between these two points. Like that, and squash. And now fold along this valley fold all the way up and flatten squash right here. And there it is. Okay. Now we're going to fold this whole part behind like that. And we're going to sink this inside. So what that means is that we're going to open up here and open up here. Actually, just open it as wide as possible. And we're gonna sink this right here, sink it. And sink this. Just, it's a closed sink, so you just have to turn it inside out and fold right along the existing crease and close it back up. And there it is. Okay, now we just have to shape the swatter, so let's see. Let's first fold this up. Straighten out my fold rule. Okay. Like that. And narrow it by folding all layers right to the middle line. And same thing over here. And just let it curve out a little bit. You can maybe go inside a little bit. But it's not going to lie flat right here, which is okay. All right, so here is the swatter. And on the back side, there's no person. On the front side, there is. All right, so the trick of it is what you do is when you show it to the audience, you go like this. You show both sides, and you see it looks like showing both sides, but I'm actually showing the same side. You see, I do a little twist as I bring it up, and a twist coming back down. Boom, boom. And it can just be done with two fingers, like that, so it doesn't look like you're doing a twist at all. All right, and then you go like that, and then actually turn it over and show the little blue man. An ancient magic trick that is now in the realm of origami. All right, bye-bye everyone. Put the metal casing back on and let's see how it works. Whoa, that is some serious flame. Dude, cool. No, but really kids, don't play with fire. Look, it's not even going out. So there's probably gas going in the room right now. We're all gonna die. All right, bye-bye everyone. Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. So you know those little blue bugs that go around getting us? Uh-oh. That was a power outage. All right, let's try this again. Take three. Hi everyone, Jeremy Schaefer here. So you know those little flu bugs that go around getting us all sick? Well, did you know that they're actually little blue men? And with this swatter, you can get it. Ooh, there's one now. Got it. Whoa. Check it out, dude.